and I would like to present you a very short overview from our point of view, what we are thinking about concerns of munition and also for risks for the Baltic Sea. If you are checking, we guys can never have this light. Could you shut down the light?
Yeah. Ingu, pajaut, Inga.
Vēl paspiedu.
Vēl, vēl, vēl.
Tur, tur, tur.
So, thank you and sorry for it.
Don't fall asleep, please.
Yeah, okay. When I was checking the literature, we marine biologists always are basing on the Helsinki Commission documents. You know, Helsinki Commission is established in 1974 for one reason, to protect the Baltic Sea. And there is Baltic Sea Environmental Proceedings number 132 about chemical munition dumped in the Baltic Sea. And this is first done 20 years ago, but anyway, this document is always upgraded, so the newest information also is included there. As you can see, the central Baltic Sea, one of the main dumping sites, is very close to Latvia border. It's a Gotland Deep on a border between Lithuania and Latvia. And another one very great and large, it's Bornholm Deep, but it is dangerous because it's spreading outside this dumped region closely year by year. But my interest mainly was, of course, about Gulf of Riga, because in this HELCOM proceedings, I found messages and information from Denmark, from Germany, from Poland, from Lithuania. Unfortunately, there was no data about the Latvia. Anyway, there are big munition concerns in the Gulf of Riga. Altogether, there are about 8,000 explosive objects from First and Second World War in the Baltic Sea. And in the Gulf of Riga, there are already checked a lot of square miles, and till now, there are found and destroyed about 800 objects. 800. 3,000 in the Gulf of Riga itself, and very important region where ships are operating and going very fast every day, as we know, it's the Irp Strait. It's about 400. In the last time, this movement is coming as international, and you know from military information, the open spirit from 2008 to 2015, international naval forces, they are trying to destroy remaining minefields to minimize the risk for shipping, fisheries and ecology. I will talk with you more about ecology. And another. So, another question which is quite serious for people who are living around the Baltic Sea in Germany, Poland, Lithuania, and Latvia. There are the white phosphorus contamination. And peoples mixed with amber. And this contamination is very dangerous because when it's dry, it flamed itself, and the temperature reaches about more than 1,000 degrees of temperature. And this is very dangerous for divers, not for professional divers, but for divers itself, and also for beach visitors. This photo is from University of Hospital of Greifswald in Germany. There are burn injuries of the person, and not very real, but anyway, also in Latvia in 90s, it was some situations where in open part of Baltic, peoples were mixed with this contamination by the amber, and it was quite bad situation. So, now more close to the science maybe. There is one very serious EU project, HEMSEA, And the main, and they were looking to the Gotland Deep. You know, this is the more deepest part of the Baltic Sea, about 240 meters. Yes, I forgot you to say, but in the Gulf of Riga, the depth is not very high. The hunger depth is only 62 meters, and therefore there is no place for dumping sites. But during wars, there are a lot of mines, torpedoes, and a lot of other things. And this HEMSI project were focused on the Gotland dump sites, also on the dispersed, unverified, and unofficial dams. One is when we know where these dams are, but where are a lot of dams which we don't know, because during war, fishes were crushing, and also with charges were lying on the bottom of the Baltic Sea. And they are trying to modeling, and they are looking for biomarker approaches to assess the situation of the living organisms in the Baltic Sea. So, what are biomarkers? They are indicator of biological state, and they could be they could show normal biological or pathogenic processes, and I think it's not difficult to understand. And they can indicate exposure to chemicals on short term or chronic and on long term. And in this HEMSI, I will show you another picture, it's more interesting for you. They did the Finnish peoples together with other countries from the Baltic Sea. They did caging, the so-called caging experiments. They took benthic organisms, mussels, who are widespread through the Baltic Sea, put them in cages, and put these cages, as you can see in this picture, in the sea. This is a scientific ship, Aranda, from Helsinki, the big ship for scientific research. And they try to get answer about this, how these mussels could live and survive in the sites where the dumping sites are. And they found that there are some genotoxic marks in these mussels. Their micronuclei was changed, and you understand in a very simple way that micronuclei are organelles in the cells for bringing genetic information. To say especially what kind of contaminants are responsible for this, it is impossible today, because in the Baltic Sea, the contamination now it's like a cocktail. And therefore, we are using biomarkers which give for us integrative answer, situation is good or bad. Our laboratory also tried to do this, but in the coastal waters, there is a brown algae, Fucus vesiculosus. You can see this Fucus vesiculosus as the more richest habitat with very diverse organisms, especially in the coastal zone. And we were together with Finns in the Beast project, and we tried to get first reactions about enzyme activity. This is okay, not for you maybe very interesting, but enzyme activity shows us very different signs in Gulf of Riga, in Finland, Gulf of Finland, and in Bothnia Bay during 3 years of the project. And unfortunately, in the Gulf of Riga, there was the highest values for this enzyme activity. It means that organisms are stressful. So, and this is, so I was preparing for a very short presentation. So thank you for attention. Maybe you have some answers in Russia, in Latvia, anyway, I can try to answer you. Thank you.
Thank you very much. And one
you
question, can we
take
have a copy?
Yeah, yes, of course, yes.
Thank you, yeah.
Yeah.
Save
on your desktop.
Yeah, just
and
could I ask you one question, please?
Yes.
How did you publicate, in which mass media, and how people or organization know your information?
Okay, about these activities or military activities you can find on the internet, on newspapers in our country. It's not how to say, closed information.
So it is newspapers, right?
Yeah, but of course our scientific investigations are published in research papers. So this information, no any information is closed. And if you go to Helsinki Commission, you will find a lot of information about these dumping sites in the Baltic Sea, about all contaminants. A lot of information is already published. So I can't agree that this is not open and this is closed information. Sorry.
Yeah, it's helcom.com.
Helcom.fi,
yeah. Yeah, yeah.
This information was also in my presentation in one of the slides.
Yeah.
Did you try to announce your results of your researching and announce and to send this information to the government? And did you get any reaction from them?
Our government knows the situation, and as I told before, Lithuanian scientists working together in the Gotland Deep, they have a very large EU project, maybe 9 or 10 countries, and everything is open, everything is published. The HEMSI report is also on internet, so everybody knows this.
Knows, but not reaction. There is no reaction.
What kind of reaction? No, there is reaction. More than 20 years, Latvian military ships are going and they are destroying these mines and charges. But first of all, it was in a very simple way. But now, in the last year, it was also observers from NATO. There are special sonars. They are going through the bottom. Yes, they are going through the bottom. They are catching up these mines and other charges.
As I tell you before, there is many years ago, when the Baltic Navy started to grow and they created even the common squadron called Baltron, especially for this purpose, to clean the mine.
And we are doing it every year.
Every year it's in general two main major mine cleaning exercise, and during this exercise it's going normally for 2 weeks, and they clean about 50 to 120 mines during these 2 weeks. Mines, torpedoes, all those.
So many questions?
Thanks.
Yeah. So thank you. This one's
fine. Yeah.
Yeah,
that's not too bad. What are the guys doing?